about lasers. Many useful inventions use lasers, so do many inventions to entertain us. For example, CD, DVD players use lasers, the barcode reader in the stores are used with lasers, doctors use lasers in various surgical operations, for example, eye surgery and heart surgery and many other surgical operations. Indian metal workers use lasers to cut and weld the metals for a very simple process into very complex processes. For example, to make a small hole in a metal to making a car. India fabric factories workers use laser to cut the millionth of fabric at once. So laser is a special form of light. Laser does not exist in nature. So the human technology won't create the laser. So laser is most important inventions mankind has ever made. Laser is a device that emits a light from the process of optical emissions stimulated through the electromagnetic radiations. So laser is a word acronym for a light amplification by stimulated emission of radiations. The first laser was built in 1960 by Theodore H. Maiman, is called ruby laser. So in 2010 has been declared the International Year of Light for the invention of ruby laser. So the Maiman used the ruby laser at the Hughes Lab for the theoretical background of C.H. Towns and Arthur Leonard. So in general, lights have more wavelength and many colors. But if we put all the colors together, we get white light. And how the laser lights are different from the ordinary light? First, the laser light is not a many wavelength. It have only one wavelength in one color. For rather than the many wavelength and many colors. So scientists say the property is called monochromatic. Second point, in the laser light, all the waves seem in phases. So, for example, all the waves are waving together with same lined up. For example, a well-timed audience in a football stadium is a best example for well-timed waving. So, scientists say the property is coherent. So, third one, in general, the white light comes from, for example, sunlight or a bulb and a flashlight, it spread out in all the directions. But in the case of laser, it does not spread out anywhere. So it comes in the same directions. So all the waves are very parallel to each other. So scientists say the property is collimator. So lasers have monochromatic, coherent and collimated. So these three properties are very useful to the society. We focus all the intense power of lasers in a particular points. So this is very useful for cutting and welding technologies in the society. So I am going to explain the theoretical background of the lasing operations. Two energy levels. So we can call it as A and B. This one is a ground state and this one is a excitation state. So the two levels have some energies. We can call it as VA and EA. So the energy level between the two levels is calculated as del E is equal to. Electron exist in the ground state. If the incident photon is coming and these electrons will take the energy from the photons and excited through its excited state. The lifetime of the ground level is infinity. The lifetime of the excited level is very small time. This 10 to the power of minus 8 seconds only. So whenever we put the photons in the ground level state of the atom, and it will take the photon and suddenly it goes to the excited state. So this is called the phenomenon of absorption. So if the electron exists in the excited state, electrons in the excited state, so the lifetime of the excited state is very, very, very low. So that it is the nanosecond level. So it will suddenly decays into a lower state. So every physical system wants to decay its energy. So it suddenly decays into a ground state with the emission of photons with same frequency. So this is naturally happened. This process is called an emission. We did not give any incident photon, so it is spontaneous emission. So these processes are very well aware of pre-Einstein states. So Einstein, he would come up with the theory of stimulated emissions. So now I am going to, if the electrons exist in the excited level, if the incident photons are coming, a very strange prediction by Einstein. So now what happens? The excited electrons, it will spontaneously emit a photon, and the incident photon also stimulate the other electrons to emit a photon. So after the emission, the two photons are coming with the same frequency. So the incident photon can stimulate the other photon to emit a photon. So this process is called stimulated emission. So now we consider the two level systems. All the atoms are placed in the ground state. So the incident photons are coming. So it will pull out and go to the excited state. So all the atoms are placed in the excited level. This is called the population inversion. So all the atoms exist in the ground state. We pulled out using photons to their excited state. We can call it a population inversion. But in the laser operation, we could maintain the population inversion at the excited state. But here we have only the two energy levels. So the atoms are excited and it is a very narrow lifetime, and it will automatically decay into the ground state. So we need the population inversion in the excited state. So the clever idea is to introduce a new level for a larger lifetime. For a laser operations, we take a three level state of the atoms, ions or molecules. So now we consider three energy levels of the atoms. We can call it as A, B and C. The energy of the level is EA, EB and EC. For the thermal equilibrium state, the energy in between the A and B levels. So now what happened? All the electrons placed in the ground level. Pull out the photons for the bumping operations. And all the atoms, all the electrons are bumped into the excited state. The lifetime of the excited state is very small, so it will rapidly decay. It will rapidly decay into the new level. So we can call it as a level, it's a metastable state. The main advantage of the metastable is a larger lifetime in a millisecond range. So we, what we can do, we using the photons to stimulate the lower energy level electrons into a higher energy level, and it automatically rapidly decay into the level C. So our aim is to pull the electrons ground level into the level C. So it will spontaneously and suddenly happen. So from the what happened in the C and A, so it spontaneously emit the photon with the frequency of H class mu, and the new photons will stimulate the other electron to exit new photons with the same frequency. So the one photon becomes two, and the two photons will continuously stimulate the other electrons to pull out the ground state. So the photons will increase for every excitations. So the one photon becomes amplified. So generally we know about the electrical amplifier, but here the light is amplified. So we can call it the phenomenon of light amplification. So this is the lasing operation. This three level indicating the ruby laser, alumina doped with chromium ions. So this indicating the three level energy systems. Now I am going to explain the ruby laser.
Okay, 13 minutes aichu, please stop panikonga.